Hello viewers, welcome to the Dateline Northeast, a program that gives an overview of the developments in India's Northeast region. I'm your host Chandrakala and here are the top stories of today's program. Union budget allocates over rupees 50,000 crore for Northeast development. Measures undertaken to control spread of encephalitis in Assam. An entrepreneur from Assam promotes Northeast artisans, weavers through digital integration. In the line of country's 10-point vision for the next decade, with a special focus on the Northeast, Nirmala Sitharaman, the finance minister, allocated over 50,000 crore rupees, the highest ever for the infrastructure development of the region. A special report.
Weeks after the BJP-led NDA coalition secured a second term under the leadership of Narendra Modi, the first annual budget 2019-2020 was unveiled by new finance minister of the country, Nirmala Sitharaman. Aimed at accelerating the growth rate of the country in coming times, the budget covered all aspects of different sectors. The ministers asserted that India will be a 5 trillion economy in few years.
Budget mein और तो सब ठीक है कपड़े के अंदर में या कई इंडस्ट्री में जो है टैक्स ज़्यादा है कपड़े में थोड़ा टैक्स कम होना चाहिए अच्छा उसके बाद जीएसटी का जो है सुधार हो रहा है बहुत अच्छा हो रहा है थोड़ा और सुधार होना चाहिए
In a significant race, Northeast Special Infrastructure Development Scheme has been allocated a sum of rupees 50,169.39 crore, up from rupees 39,201 crore in 2018-2019, to further proliferate the number of development projects underway in the region. To ensure the development and trust to the Northeast region, the overall budget allocated to the Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region is rupees 3,000 crore as compared to rupees 2,629 crore in financial year 2018-2019.
एक रुपया आया तो आया है बाकी ड्यूटी अच्छी होना सही है कि अभी सुना है पेट्रोल पंप में वो तेल भी कमती आता है किसी किसी साइड में वो ऐसा सुना था पहले वो न्यूज़ में आया था इस सब में और पेट्रोल का जो क्वालिटी है अभी पेट्रोल पंप में उस क्वालिटी में कुछ देखभाल या कुछ अच्छा होने का कोशिश करे वो ये सरकार और जो एक्साइज वाला है वो लोग अच्छी तरह से ड्यूटी करे क्योंकि हम लोगों से तो ये टैक्स लेता ही है एक रुपये एक लीटर में
एज पर रिपोर्ट्स द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज वेरी सेंसिटिव टू दिस इश्यूज दे आर ट्राइंग हार्ड टू रिवाइव द इकोनॉमी आई एम श्योर the economy will revive, provided there is no major international crisis like hike in petroleum prices.
Under this budget, railways will receive a major facelift and will encourage to invest more in suburban railways, which will help the railway projects.
ये ज़्यादा financial budget तो नहीं social budget ज़्यादा लग रहा था. Finance के हिसाब से देखा जाए अगर तो railways में जो public-private partnership का बोला है. वो मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लगा इससे क्या होगा कि रेलवेज़ का डेवलपमेंट अभी तो बहुत तेज़ी से हो ही रहा है अब पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप की वजह से और इसका रेट बढ़ जाएगा तो हम ये देखेंगे कि लास्ट मतलब नेक्स्ट 5 to 10 ईयर्स में अभी जो रेलवेज़ का सिचुएशन है नेक्स्ट 5 to 10 ईयर्स में और ज़्यादा अच्छा रहेगा
Hailing the union budget, the Northeast region have termed the budget as balanced and positive and hopes that this new budget will expedite the progress of the poor and bring reforms in the Indian economy.
As Bihar continues to grapple with acute encephalitis that has killed more than 120 children, Northeastern state of Assam is taking steps to curtail the spread of the JE that has claimed lives of more than 40 people recently. A central team arrived in the state to review the situation and full-fledged measures are being taken by the government to contain the disease. Bihar continues to reel as acute encephalitis has hit the state, claiming lives of hundreds of people. Similar situation is taking place in Assam, where Japanese encephalitis has claimed more than 40 lives as per latest reports. Recently, a team of senior officers from Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, headed by Regional Secretary Health Sanjeev Kumar, visited the state and took stock of the situation.
We need to do a bit extra on the score of adult vaccination. And in fact, 13 districts are already covered under adult JE vaccination, and remaining the state government wants this center to help them in covering the remaining districts.
As many as 29 out of 33 districts are affected by the disease, and most cases are reported in Upper Assam districts including Tinsukia, Jorhat, Dibrugarh, Sivasagar. According to health official of Jorhat Medical College, the number of acute encephalitis syndrome cases in JMC is 30, out of which 13 are found to be Japanese encephalitis positive cases.
Till now, we have I'll give you the data from June onwards, because this is the peak season where you get JE cases mostly. Number of AES cases, acute encephalitis syndrome cases admitted to Jorhat Medical College Hospital is 30, out of which 13 were found to be JE positive cases. And deaths till now, if we start from June, it is 5 AES cases, out of which four were found to be Japanese encephalitis positive. At present, we have got 10 patients admitted, out of which one is positive for JE.
The situation in Assam's Guwahati city is grimmer as every day more cases are being reported, and to control the spread of disease, the National Health Mission Assam is taking extensive measures to thwart the disease. The government is working to upgrade medical facilities in order to provide better treatment to one suffering from the deadly disease.
Regarding the control measure and prevention, we are now, our field workers are doing the fever survey in the community level. And if there is any positive cases there, then in surrounding 50 houses or up to the 2 kilometer radius, that fogging is already, they are doing, instruction is given already.
Moreover, in Assam Medical College, AMC, in Dibrugarh, the growing number of cases of Japanese encephalitis has given rise to tension and worries among family members of the patients. The sad scenario is that children of age group of 1 to 12 years are being admitted every day. It is worth noting that the government is taking emergency measures to overcome the situation with minimum fatality, which includes special transport allowances for patients suffering from JE. A dedicated help desk for guiding the AES-JE patients will be set up in all medical colleges to ensure faster service delivery.
We have taken number of steps. We have intensified blood sample collection. So far, 12 lakhs blood sample we have collected. We have given instruction to state government authorities to cancel all the leave of doctor and paramedical staff so that they can remain engaged with patient. They will not be given any leave up to 30th September. Then we have also given financial incentive such as all treatment in ICU will be, from now onwards, will be free, so that no poor will be deprived from taking treatment.
Meanwhile, the government has urged the people to not delay treatment and take early precautions in order to avoid any kind of fatality or disability. Moving on, the Northeast region is known for its exquisite handicrafts products. In today's episode, let's meet a young startup entrepreneur from Assam who is promoting local artisans, weavers of the Northeast region through digital integration. Officially launched in 2017, the web portal named Brahmaputra Fables is providing job opportunity to nearly 3,000 local artisans. A report.
Northeast handicrafts are known worldwide for its eco-friendly products, and it forms an integral part of the lifestyle of the indigenous people of the region. To preserve the invaluable traditional skills of local artisans, weavers and designers of the region, 27-year-old entrepreneur Dharuba Jyoti Deka from Sarthebari village in Assam runs a digital integration portal, Brahmaputra Fables.
Northeastern handicrafts are special. They are made from hands, and like there are so many varieties of Northeastern handicrafts available. But this e-commerce is reviving Northeastern handicrafts in a way that these things never reach the global market. People are like selling locally, but these crafts, some are getting endangered because there is no global market, not a like broad market available for them. So we started Brahmaputra Fables so that through this e-commerce website they can sell without any storage cost, without any middleman, and they can connect to the customers directly through our portal.
After his master's degree in chemistry from Pondicherry University in 2016, he, along with his junior friend, launched the e-commerce portal after seeing the interest that people had about the region's rich culture and attires. Sartebari village in Assam is famous for its brass and bell metal work. Through this digital platform, the craftsmen are able to keep the age-old culture alive and earn their livelihood.
I always wanted Brahmaputra River to be in my startup's name because it is inspired from Amazon, and Amazon is the largest river in South America, and from that only the biggest e-commerce website of the world got inspired. So that's why I always wanted the Brahmaputra River to be Brahmaputra River name to be in my startup, and fables means tales. So my startup will always spread the tales from the mighty river of Northeast India.
Brahmaputra Fables was officially launched in June 2017 with 30 artisans on board selling 100 products and is currently incubated at the Nest and Incubator in collaboration with Government of Assam and IIM Calcutta Innovation Park. Around 3,000 artisans are working under Brahmaputra Fables. Through this platform, the artisans connect with the customers directly. The artisans also get customer orientation training. The startup keeps only 10 to 20% of the sales of the products. It has shipped rich and vibrant products across the world, including the United States, United Kingdom, Australia, and Italy.
मैं बेंबो का सामान बनाता हूँ, जैसे आपका बेंबो का पेन, लाइट, फर्नीचर डिजाइन का कुछ प्रोडक्ट, उसके साथ आपका लकड़ी का भी कुछ प्रोडक्ट देता हूँ। उसके साथ मतलब अच्छा एक तालमेल हो रहा है और जो रेस्पॉन्स अच्छा जो रेस्पॉन्स मिल रहा है बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है हम लोग को.
Initiatives like these will not only integrate the stories of the local crafts and artisans, but helps in improving the sales of craftsmen products and educating customers about the rich products of the Northeast region. Brahmaputra Fables now aims to integrate more artisans and spread the tales from the mighty rivers of Northeast India to around the world.
Let us now take a look at some of the events that made news in the Northeast recently.
Indian sprinter Hima Das from Assam won her second international gold in women's 200 meter with a top finish at the Kutno Athletics meet in Poland. Hima, who has been struggling with a back problem for the past few months, clocked 23.97 seconds to clinch the gold, while VK Vismaya bagged the silver in 24.06 seconds. The 19-year-old won her first gold medal in the 400-meter final at the IAAF World Under 20 Championships 2018 held in Tampere, Finland. Cloudburst in Arunachal Pradesh, leading to massive rainfall and flash flood, has made life in the state miserable. Several are stranded and some reported missing in flood in Tengapani area of Bhalukpong in Arunachal. The army and paramilitary forces, along with disaster management authorities, have been deployed to rescue the victims. An RCC bridge between Kaspi and Nagmandir has also been washed away by flood water. Whereas in Assam, devastating flash flood has affected several districts of the state, including Dhemaji, Lakhimpur, Biswanath Charyali, Barpeta, to name a few. Around 145 villages are submerged in the flood water, affecting nearly 62,419 people as per latest reports. Meghalaya too reeled under massive flood, and heavy landslides caused due to heavy rain has left several others stranded in Assam's Guwahati city. Recently, Chief Minister of Meghalaya Conrad K. Sangma launched the website of Meghamart from his office chamber in the presence of co-chair of Young Leaders Connect 6, Larsing Soyan, members of YLC, local entrepreneurs and other officials. Speaking during the launch, Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma said that the launch of the website is an initiative to develop the entire entrepreneurial ecosystem in the state. He also informed that the government will soon come up with the procurement policy so that all government, military and paramilitary and private organizations will purchase 20% of their requirements from these entrepreneurs of the state. In the wake of a number of bombs being exploded at residential areas, Imphal East and West District Police has taken a precautionary drive to avoid any untoward incidents. Search operations were carried recently at Khwairamban Ima Kethil in Imphal West. It may be mentioned that several bombs have exploded at Khurai MLA's residence and other areas of the city. To avoid such untoward incidents, Imphal West District Commando and team of the City Police conducted search operation at Khwairamban Ima Kethil area. During the operation, about 300 persons were verified, out of which 12 persons who failed to produce valid identification documents were detained and handed over to City Police Station for further verification. As the state of Assam is facing a serious threat of floods, the courageous act of this 11-year-old boy named Uttam is grabbing headlines. Brave and gutsy Uttam from Misamari, Assam, jumped into a river in Assam when he saw a woman and her child struggling in the water. The young boy not only managed to stay afloat in the rising water level, but also saved the women and the toddler. While speaking to ANI, Lakhya Jyoti Das, district magistrate, said the woman was trying to cross a small river with her two kids when water in the river suddenly increased.
Northeast region has produced many national and international sportsmen for the country. To keep these young pugilists focused and to hone their boxing skills, the state organizes various training and championships. One such event was a recent edition of the Second Boxing Federation of India Elite Men's East Zone Boxing Championship, organized by Meghalaya Boxing Association in collaboration with New Era Sports Social and Cultural Club. I report.
Boxers of the Northeast region have immense potential, and much of the Northeastern pugilist, right from the junior division to the youth and in the elite categories, could be seen pursuing their skills passionately. To promote and bolster the sports culture in the region, Meghalaya Boxing Association, in collaboration with New Era Sports Socio and Cultural Club, organized the Second Boxing Federation of India Elite Men's East Zone Boxing Championship in Shillong recently. The two-day-long championship was held at the U Tirot Singh Indoor Stadium. Boxers from Meghalaya, Sikkim, Assam and West Bengal participated in the championship.
Our youths are deriving from the sports and the development of the society, their sports, they are diverted into a very evil things. So for their development, so for their only, we want to show them this kind of tournament, this kind of events, which will really convert their mind, or they can change their life, so it will be betterment for them and for their life.
In the championship, Assam bagged 4 gold, 2 silver and a bronze, while Meghalaya stood second position with 2 gold and 5 silvers. Whereas Sikkim won 1 gold and 5 bronze, and West Bengal got 6 bronze in zonal rankings.
Even though I am engineer for now, I will try my best to continue the boxing. Boxing is my hobby. After I left football, for the football also I am a district player. And now I represent Meghalaya for the boxing. And this is the big opportunities for me.
The gold winners from Assam were Mridu Pavan Barua, Ansula Basu Matri, Sam Bahadur Pradhan and Tanmoy Dovaro. Meghalaya Sharbong Lang, Marban Yang and Arthur Corneli Kongjio won gold medals in their respective events of the second Elite Men's East Zone Boxing Championship.
State government wo kar raha hai, help kar raha hai, acha kar raha hai, aur abhi bhi all kar raha hai kyunki further planning chal raha hai. So I hope ki in future Sikkim mein bhi boxing acha hoga.
As long as these boxers continue their hard work and keep themselves focused, it will be an exciting moment not only for the boxers, but it will encourage the young players of the region. Though championships like these identify the potentials of the players, they can only become a reality when the boxers continue to excel in their sports culture.
Let me take you to the enchanting states of the northeastern region, where Jagannath Rath Yatra, or the Chariot Festival, is being celebrated with same spiritual fervor along with the rest of the country. Let's have a look. Along with the rest of the country, the states of the Northeast region too came alive with the celebration of Jagannath Rath Yatra or Chariot Festival. In Assam's Guwahati city, the festival is observed with full devotion and spirituality. A sea of people is seen pulling the beautifully decorated chariot of the deities. Hymns of Hare Krishna, Hare Rama reverberated the atmosphere as devotees took to the street for the procession.
ये रथ हम लोग कर रहे हैं विश्व शांति के लिए आनंद के लिए भगवान को आशीर्वाद सबको मिलेगा क्योंकि भगवान को देखने के लिए बहुत कोई आदमी जाने नहीं सकता है मंदिर में तो ये रथ यात्रा में भगवान खुद निकल के आता है सबको आशीर्वाद करने के लिए सबको दर्शन देने के लिए
In Manipur's Imphal city, Rath Yatra or Kang in Manipuri is celebrated amidst much gaiety and fervor. Kang is a major festival of the Vaishnavite Maitha community of the valley and holds immense significance. It is noteworthy that the festival was introduced to Manipur in the early part of the 19th century during the reign of Gambhir Singh. The famous Govindaji temple is all decked up and a large number of devotees are flocking the temple to offer prayers.
Adi mangatarande adi matung ta gasi bhawa liepna chathari adu mi se chahi khuding yang phalei hakum jumi yam yami kumsi isei ka hor gor pa ma khang ni adu huli adu ki phim lei dan ma da oi ba adu ka pun ya atma shanti oi ba shanti ki phim ma oi ba adu ki phim
The 10-day long festival begins on the second day in the bright fortnight of Asad month. Similar spirit is witnessed in Tripura's capital Agartala, where thousands of devotees are thronging the famous Jagannath temple of the state to pull the chariot of Lord Jagannath. As history goes, in the year 1905, Maharaj Radha Kishore Manika had built the Jagannath temple, which is east-facing like the famous Jagannath temple of Puri. The deities in the temple were also brought from Puri, and the festival began in Tripura some 114 years back.
না এখানে আমি তো অনেক ছোটবেলা থেকে আসি হ্যাঁ আমাদের বাড়ি আগরতলাতে তো এখন তো আমার বয়স হয়েছে ছেলে আছে নাতি নাতনি আছে ওদেরকে নিয়ে এসেছি যে আজকে জগন্নাথ বাড়িতে এসে এনজয় করব পূজার প্রসাদ খাব জগন্নাথ দর্শন করব এসে দেখলাম বেশ আনন্দে লাগছে খুব ভালো লাগছে সবাই মিলে প্রসাদ খেয়েছি অনেক দর্শনার্থী এসেছে অনেকের সাথে কথা হয়েছে তারপরে কীর্তন হয়েছে এখানে খুব ভালো লেগেছে
Rath Yatra is a Hindu festival associated with Lord Jagannath held at Puri in the state of Orissa in the eastern India. The Yatra marks the ancient traditions and it is the oldest Rath Yatra taking place in India and the world whose descriptions can be found in holy scriptures such as Brahma Puran, Padma Puran and Skanda Puran and Kapila Samhita. The festival commemorates Jagannath's annual visit to Gundicha Temple via Mossi Ma Temple, maternal aunt's home near Balagandhi, Chakapuri. The Rath Yatra is among the few Hindu festivals which unify people, irrespective of caste, creed and religion, and spreads a message of peace and harmony. With that, we have come to the end of this episode of Roving Report. Do connect with us through Facebook page and follow us on Twitter at @anyindia_ANI. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get latest news updates from the Northeast. I'm your host, Chandra Kala, signing off. Goodbye and take care.